Microplastics are plastic pieces smaller than 5 millimeters in size. The small size might make them hard to notice, but the pollution caused by them is significant. In this video, let's look at where these microplastics come from and how they are polluting the world. This video is in collaboration with the Simple Environmentalist. Once you finish watching this video, go check out the video on her channel where she talks about the steps we can take to reduce microplastic pollution. I'll leave a link to her video in the description. It's a well-known fact that we create huge amounts of plastic waste every single day. Things like plastic bags and straws usually come to mind when we think of plastic pollution. But meanwhile, we are also creating a lot of microplastic waste, which is threatening the environment in many ways. Here's a quick list of 6 sources of microplastic pollution. 1. The microbeads in shampoos, body scrubs, and even toothpaste are all microplastics. These get washed into the drains that may lead to water bodies. 2. Most glitter we find in the market today are nothing but tiny pieces of plastic. 3. When synthetic materials like polyester, nylon, and acrylic are washed, they release several plastic microfibers into the water. 4. Car tires and brake pads can produce tiny particles as they wear down over time. These particles are super small and can be easily blown away by the winds. 5. Larger plastic waste may break down over time under the effect of heat, sunlight, waves, and physical pressure to form microplastics. 6. Some manufacturers add certain additives to plastic products to help them break down more easily in nature. It's commonly misunderstood that such plastics will break down into organic materials, but sadly, they will just disintegrate into smaller microplastics. Due to their small size, microplastics can be easily carried away by winds or water currents, and it's very difficult to clean them up. They're so small, they can even pass through water treatment plants unnoticed. They are very difficult to manage, and that is what makes them so dangerous. A lot of these microplastics have accumulated in the oceans all over the world. The Pacific Ocean is now home to the largest accumulation of ocean plastic called the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. This patch covers 1.6 million square kilometers and contains about 1.8 trillion pieces of plastic. And 94% of these items are microplastics. Many small creatures mistake the plastic for food and end up ingesting them. These small creatures may then get eaten by bigger animals, and the plastic continues to pass through the food cycle, putting all living beings at risk, including humans. Ocean plastic is increasing at such a rate, it is predicted that by 2050, there will be more plastic than fish in the sea. As more plastic accumulates in the oceans, it may block sunlight from reaching marine organisms. Marine plants like the phytoplankton depend on this sunlight for photosynthesis, through which they release oxygen. Without proper sunlight, they might die. Since they form the base of the marine food cycle, it can lead to starvation of many organisms. Marine plants like these are also responsible for the production of around 70% of the world's oxygen. So you can imagine how important they are to all life on Earth. Traces of microplastics have been found even in tap water, beer, and sea salt. They may even be present in the air which we may be inhaling. A study commissioned by the WWF revealed that an average person may be consuming around 5 grams of plastic per week, which is equal to consuming a whole credit card. Microplastics may break down even further into what is termed as nanoplastics. Though there is not enough research on this topic yet, it's possible that particles of such small size can penetrate tissues of organisms and can even be absorbed by plants through their roots. Microplastics have traveled far and wide, and now they're everywhere. In the oceans, in our food, in the air we breathe, in the snow in the Arctic and Antarctic. It's even been found in rainwater. Microplastics have given rise to a macro level problem. But don't worry, all is not lost. We can still take small, simple steps as individuals that can really make a difference in this world. To know more about what you can do to reduce microplastics, watch the video on the Simple Environmentalist. Make sure you check out her channel and subscribe. If you learned something new from this video, do leave a comment and a like. And if you're new here, subscribe to this channel as well. Thank you for watching.